Melancholies use a methodical approach to navigate life, and in this podcast, we are going to further discover the natural wiring of a true melancholy. After listening to the four temperament summaries I outlined in my podcast titled Wired Step 2, you may already be labeling yourself as this particular temperament. However, I urge you not to box yourself into believing you are solely a melancholy, as nearly all of us are a blend of at least two of the four temperaments. For your benefit, I created a document titled Character Traits and posted it under the Downloads tab of my website, thriveintherealworld.com. As you listen to this podcast, use the document to follow along, focusing on the melancholies column. Circle any words or phrases as described in this podcast that speak directly to you. Let's begin. Melancholies are intense logical thinkers and extremely cautious individuals. They speak the language of order and perfection and influence their environment by adhering to the existing rules. They communicate in an honest, sincere, and factual manner. Melancholies operate from a plan and are detail-oriented. The task of a melancholy may never see the finish line, but every detail will be given full attention. The ability to gather, analyze, and organize facts allows a melancholy to excel in research. As natural problem solvers, they are able to see obstacles, think of all the possible outcomes, and find creative solutions. Once they figure something out, they tend to get bored and may just move on. Melancholies are constantly raising the bar to encourage excellence and achieve perfection. They have high standards for not only themselves, but for everyone else, which can easily lead to disappointment and criticism. Melancholies are hard to please, moody, and hate to be interrupted. Resistant to change, melancholies tend to have a negative attitude toward anything new until they've had ample time to think it through. Determined to make the right and best decisions, melancholies will collect an abundance of data and ask very specific questions, sometimes asking the same question several times. They may take excessive time to think about all their options before making a decision, and even then, they are unsure if it's the right one. Melancholies are highly driven to get things right, as being precise is more important than protecting their egos. They need reassurance and feedback based on logical reasoning that they are on the right path. Melancholies are naturally quality-oriented and very private. They are well-organized, however, on occasion they may keep things cluttered, but will know what's in all of those piles. They are conscientious, picky, and can be sensitive to the opinions of others. Melancholies fear taking risks, making wrong decisions, and being viewed as incompetent. They are prone to be pessimistic and worrisome as they focus on the negatives and think of the worst-case scenarios. Melancholies have anxiety about the present and future, robbing them of joy. They fail to realize that guilt will not change the past, nor will worry change the future. Trusting someone or something does not come easy to a melancholy, as they are skeptical of just about everything. They will suspiciously dissect every word and read between every line for the sake of probing into a person's true intentions. Unforgiving in nature, a melancholy will end a relationship if trust is broken, holding a grudge for a lengthy amount of time. Hopefully, after listening to the podcast, along with the other three podcasts individually titled Choleric, Phlegmatic, and Sanguine, you have been able to circle quite a few words and phrases listed on the character traits document. The ultimate goal is for you to narrow down your selections to reveal your dominant character traits, as these are the ones that influence the way you relate and communicate on a daily basis. Check out my next two podcasts titled 7 Areas Part 1 and 7 Areas Part 2, where I compare cholerics to sanguines and phlegmatics to melancholies. I believe you will not only see yourself in some of the descriptions, but might just recognize a few people you know.